Good evening, all of you. Today, I and Amit are going to present our software, that is XCauseN Web. I'll give a brief info what XCause is. The aim of our project was to port all the functionalities of XCause to a browser-only version because it can be available to user 24 hours and he can access it via any machine which has internet connectivity. The next is overall system design. The user is provided with a graphical user interface, that is web browser, through which he can drag and drop any block and make a diagram and pass it to server. The server will simulate it and give a PNG back to the user as a result of the simulation. Now this is the flowchart. First of all, the server will start, then it will display the editor and the palette with all the blocks. The user then can make a diagram and the MX graph will create a raw XML from the JSON which will be created by data structures of that particular block which he have dragged. Then XSLT will convert the required MX graph XML into XCause and it will send to the server. Now the server will simulate diagram and display the result back to the browser. This is the graphical user interface which we have created. You can see there are many blocks and links are created between ports of different blocks. So this is the diagram which when simulated gives a PNG. These are the features of GUI. We can set block parameters. That is, for every block there are certain parameters which can be set. Then there's a right click functionality of zoom in, zoom out, etc. Then there's color wheel and port constraints. For example, an explicit output port can only be connected to explicit input port. And a command prompt can only be connected to control port. If we connect otherwise, then it will show an error. Then there's tooltip, setup, and export XCause. There's color wheel. If we choose a color, then it will display in the background. And see, you can see when we have tried to connect explicit output port with a control port, it shows error that it cannot be connected. The next is converter, which...
Good evening, all of you. Actually, we have used Python for and Regex to convert the data structure, which are in Scilab, in JavaScript. So as we can implement in the client side. So we don't have to use the data structure in the server side. This is a state diagram which we have used for the converter. First of all, we check the state. If we are using Scilab, there are various data types in Scilab. We have Scilab double, Scilab string, and Scilab integer. So this is a state diagram which depicts how we are converting the Scilab data structure in the equivalent JavaScript data structure. This is the workflow of our converter. And it extracts the function name, and it extracts all the defined cases of the data structure, and it converts it into equivalent JavaScript.
There are various basic blocks which cannot be converted by the converter, which was specified by him, because these are the basic ones, and these are the building blocks of that blocks which he have converted using that converter. So there are many data structures like SkyCause links, SkyCause blocks, and some other. These have been created by me, and you can see they are using this is the above sky file for that SkyCause link and the JavaScript function which we have made. As you can see, it uses Scilab double and all other such type of data types which we have also implemented. Scilab double is used to store matrix of double type. You can also say that we could have used double, int, or something, but we have used Scilab. We have made our own data types just to make it more familiar to the XCause that will be required at the end. There are functions which were not defined by Scilab. We have added these functions so that to make it more efficient and effective.
All this is JavaScript.
Yeah, all this is JavaScript. And there are some internal operators as well, which we have re-implemented. There's... I have done a whole JavaScript. Malab, there were 230 blocks, out of which 100 has been implemented right now. For one block, there was 2,000 lines. मतलब नॉट फॉर ऑल ब्लॉक्स बट सम हैड 100 लाइंस सम हैड टू 1000 लाइंस आई डोंट नो एग्जैक्टली बेसिक ब्लॉक्स राइट इट इज देयर इज कंबाइंड ऑन जेएस इनसाइड दैट देयर आर 230 ब्लॉक्स
सो नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द एक्सेसिबिलिटी एक्चुअली we have implemented the front end with the MX graph. So it wraps the whole data in an XML format. But that format is not compatible with the Xcause. So Xcause has an XSD which defines the rule that that any block can contain this format of XML. So we made use of that XSD to make our make the rule for our transformation so that this data from our generated by our GUI according to the rules, will be converted in accordance to the Xcause so that we can simulate it in the server.
Now, this is the simulation. See, the user has created a diagram on the left side, and if he clicks on simulation, he'll get this simulated diagram. There are various server components. For example, Java Servlet has been used at backend to get to import the matlab to get the Xcause file and to give the image back, and Nginx has been used above it. There are some future work which have to be implemented. For example, we need a dynamic interaction. Right now, a PNG has been passed by the server, but what we want is user can. For example, you have seen TK scale on from Xcause and desktop. So that functionality needs to be implemented. Moreover, we do not want a PNG back. We want XY coordinate back so that we can implement. We can make ourselves can make that.
Okay.
We have made documentation.
And all soft copies are left with the corresponding.
Okay.
I'll show the demo. There are various.
Okay. Let next.
Okay.
Because demo is going to be the same as the Xcause without the web, correct?
For example, if this is the diagram, then it will get simulated.
Why?
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.